All right, joining me today is Michelle Myers talking about what to do if you got engaged over the holiday season. Seems to be a popular time to get engaged every year.
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, between mid-November and mid-February, 60% of all engagements happen. And that's like a regular statistic that happens year after year.
Wow, okay. Yeah. So pretty much between then and Valentine's Day, and your Instagram feed is covered in people getting engaged. So when you do get engaged, where should you start? It's a big thing to plan. So what is the number one thing you should start doing?
Absolutely. I think the number one thing people should start doing is making that guest list. You can cut the guest list, you can add to the guest list, but you really have to start with a foundation of how many people you want at your wedding, who you want at your wedding, in order to create your budget, which would be the next step kind of thing, or even first if you're working with a really strict budget.
Awesome. And so when you do come into your budget, so what are some things that you should really kind of invest in for your big day? Mm-hmm. And what are some of the things you can save your money on?
I think that people should choose their investment based on what they find valuable about a wedding. Some people are going to spend a lot of their money on photography, which of course is great too, because it's a long-term investment that way. Other people are foodies and they love food and they want a great meal for their guests and they may spend money there. So there's not like a specific item that I would say spend your money on or don't spend your money on. Certainly if you're not specific about location or don't care as much about that, look for a cheaper venue, different costs that way, as well as decor is a big one. Mm-hmm. If you're willing to do the work yourself, obviously it can cost you a lot less.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so once you've established your budget and your guest list, where's kind of the next place you should go?
I would look for a venue. After, of course, in all, amongst all of this, I haven't said, but choose a date.
Yes, of course.
But look for your venue. So that would be the next thing. Venues are things that will book up the fastest. So you want to make sure you lock that down.
Yeah. And so for someone who is looking to get married, and is it beneficial for them to hire someone at, like yourself, like an event planner, to really, detail? Because how hard is it to plan this all on your own?
It depends how extravagant the wedding is and what the bride or groom's interests are. A lot of people don't like planning, and that's where I come in and do it for you. You could have a great day, be stress-free, and not worry about it. And then other times, brides want to do all that work, and that's, fine. to each their own. I personally suggest weekend of coordination packages for anybody, and not just me as an event planner, but for anybody. And that's only because you don't have to stress about it the weekend of. You get to really go and enjoy your wedding and not worry if those detail things are taken care of.
Yeah. So. And we were just kind of talking off camera. Weddings aren't just for Saturdays anymore. You're saying it's kind of trendier, or it's becoming a trend to get married on other days of the week.
Yeah, so people are finding it easier to book in with a shorter time period, as well as less expensive to get married on Fridays and Sundays.
Yeah.
Even midweek weddings are becoming a thing.
Wow.
So it just depends where you are. A bigger center, it is definitely cheaper to get married on a different day than Saturday. Lloydminster, not as much, just because we don't have as much competition.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you so much for sharing all those tips if you got engaged over the holidays, or maybe you're about to get engaged, as it seems to be the time. So thank you so much. And if for anyone looking for your services, where can they contact you?
Absolutely. Check out Easter Merlot on Facebook, or type it in on Google and you'll find me.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Michelle, for joining us today, talking with us.